everyone. This is Patty. I'm here today with a design team project for the Piece by Piece. And I have made this altered little canister. This started out as cardboard. And I didn't show step by step because I had no idea what I was going to do with it when I started. Now, I want you to see, and it's hard to film here, that you can support it by just the little birdcage on the top. This, as I said, was cardboard, and what I did was I took Golden Matte Medium, Liquitex, the white gesso, then I added Magical Michaels from Lindy's, the cocoa bean, and some Micro Pearl Pearlettes, and mixed them all together to get this creamy rose color. And I really like, I painted the outside and I painted the inside. And I really like how that turned out and I like the feel of it. Next, what I did was I took, this is Mother Nature paper. It's called Flock. And I love these little birds here with the bird feeder. So I fussy cut the little birds out and this little bird here. And I took, the matte medium and attached the birds onto the side of the canister. And then I took the other single bird and I popped him up, I think you can see it, on black chipboard so that he's dimensional, stands out a little bit more. Around the bottom I took the gray tulle, the tutu tulle. And there are two rows of this. One row points down, one row points up to give it a fullness. I covered, after I painted the bottom and it dried, I covered it with paper. And I covered the inside as well. That's the back side of this paper is the print. I covered the inside as well. And you can see, I didn't like just the plain look of the inside. So I took this lace. This is the floral Venice lace in the white, but I didn't want white because everything is mostly gray on this. So I used Lindy's Steel Shimmerous. This is Glitz. And I also have this Black Magic from Tattered Angels, but it's really not theirs anymore because I've added Pearlettes and water and a bunch of other stuff to it. And between all of those, I came up with this really pretty gray that I put just on the inside. Now, I attach this Tim Holtz hitch fastener here, and it looks like a bird perch, yes, but the reason I did it is this is the top of the bird feeder, and I didn't want it to go beyond there because I want you to be able to see the little bird. So I attached the hitch post there so it will stop my lid from going any further down. That's the reason for that. Now I took these flowers. These are the Daisy Vintage Lace Flowers in Mauve. I just love these. And I cut them apart and I have one here and I took the silver or the gray, I'm not sure which it's called, flatback pearl with the rhinestones around them, and you can see the gorgeous colors they come in Bev's Etsy store. So I took the silver gray ones and I put it right in the middle of one of those flowers that I cut for a flower center, and I have another one here. But here, let me get the lid and we'll come back to this butterfly in just a minute. On the lid, I covered it with paper, inside and out, and I painted the whole thing, you can see. And then I took and I applied the Beacon's Fabri-Tac all around the edge and around here, and I used this, this is the French cotton crochet lace in the gray and white. Love this lace. I think this is probably one of my favorites out of her store. So I applied it so that it went right around the edge here, then I just carefully eased it over with the Fabri-Tac and glued it down. And in the middle, you can see these are these cut in half. Half, half, half. There's three halves here. And then I put the gray tulle. And then this is a Jolie's Jewels. Someone had given this to me a long time ago, and it's been in my stash of stuff. And there's a little tiny bird. I don't know. Come on, focus, if the camera's going to pick it up or not. The still photos will pick it up. I'll make sure I get a shot. But there's a little tiny bird in there. And I don't know. I haven't decided whether I should attach a chain to this or not. Now, I had one half of these three left. So what I did was I cut the half in half and made quarters. And then I made a butterfly. Just by putting the two together. This is a piece of the of this crochet lace. And I just snipped it down into it to create kind of a flower underneath. This is the two pieces of the rose, the mauve flower. And I put a stone in the middle. And then for the antenna, I had these little stamens that I bought in the wedding section to use with my flowers. And they just worked out perfectly. So that's basically what I have done. And I just think this is going to be a gift for a friend, and I'm going to fill it with some goodies, and I just think this was a fun, fun project. Be sure and check out Bev's Etsy store. The link to the store and the link to all of the supplies that I used will be in the About section. You just need to expand it so it opens up and you see the supply list. If you're not a subscriber, I hope you'll become one today. Comments are always welcomed, most appreciated, and I do try to answer each one individually. So I hope you'll leave me a comment. Thanks for joining me today, and check out, like I said, Bev's store and buy some of these beautiful, beautiful laces that she has. Thanks a lot. Oh, one other thing, forgot. After I applied the gesso and the matte medium, and I still, it was too brown a color on my canister here, so I've forgotten, I used this Alpine Ice Rose over it and just sprayed it. This is a Lindy's, a Starburst spray, and sprayed it over, and that's what gave this really pretty pinky rose color to the whole thing. Almost forgot to tell you about that, and that's what just made the color. So there we are. And you just line that up. I did use glossy accents or 3D lacquer, I can't remember which one, on the top lid of the bird feeder here. So thanks a lot for joining me. Have a great crafty day, and I'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.